Hello, Ranos here, and welcome to episode of Minecraft. Now in this episode, I'm going to be showing you something hidden. Ignore what's out there. And in here, it looks like just a normal library, I guess, quite small. Some of you may have just noticed something. Button. Press that button, and look at it go! Long tunnel. With quite a lot of pistons. And then here we go. A treasure room. With all my treasure. Nobody touchy. Yeah, there's a button over there for something. And boom! And that closes the whole thing up. And that's pretty much a hidden room. But how about I show you how it works when it's opened. All I've got to do is go this way. Hit that button again. Then head outside and I'll be able to show you the redstone to it. It's quite a simple little creation, nothing too fancy. And here we go, that's pretty much it. Use the redstone repeaters, all like that, in order to get to do it right. And adding layers and layers of repeaters on in order for it to keep going. And you can actually have this going unlimitedly. Have going all the way to God knows where. Really far. The way to make this most compact would be to use command blocks, but I don't know how to use them yet. We'll worry about those later. Or you can just ask Seth Bling. He'll probably come up with something for it in a few seconds. Yeah. And this here is the button on the other side of the wall inside the room, which travels all the way down here to this part. This is pretty much how we have a single button activating and deactivating the whole thing. Since the signal from the button needs to go to two different places. It needs to go here in order to activate the whole thing, and needs to go here to reset it. That's what this little thingy does. When the signal goes through here, for the block on this one, it will activate the system. That will send a signal all the way down to all the pistons. First, these are on a bit of a delay so that the signal can get all the way to here, which operates the two pistons below it. Well, four, technically. I'm still wondering how it does it, because it's just got redstone on top here, and yet it triggers four pistons. I'm not sure how that works. But anyway, once it does that, that will trigger that'll turn off, allowing this to pull backwards, allowing this switch to trigger the reset. Pretty much allows that button to do the same thing. But now, how about we press it from out here, so you can view what it likes here. Goes off like that, signal goes off slowly. And you see, here it's also done the same thing. Yeah, it's an interesting little thing. Let's press it again, activate, and that'll turn on. As I said, that delays to make sure it moves time. Because before, when I didn't have that delay in, it was activating and resetting it at the same time. Because the signal got through to this a bit too soon. Kind of annoying, but oh well. Because these remained active for too long. But it's all sorted and it's getting dark. Which we do not want. And in order to get to the other side, I've just made it go under. It took a while since I had to fiddle around with the repeaters. Because in default state, each repeater takes up one tick. And when it's in full, like that one, it takes up four ticks. So you got to plan it out properly. Now here, that's three ticks, and that's also three ticks. That's in order for it to... I get down. So go with this one, which is on two ticks. And with this one, which is on one tick, both of those putting it to three ticks. And that has a bit of a delay for some reason. Oh yes, because the end ones was activating too quickly. Only one tick on that. Well, that's two ticks. And the one here is also at two ticks. You know, so they don't fire off too quickly. Which is handy. That's why one's coming from this button, it's just one tick for each of them. Just because, well, it doesn't really need to be any longer. And it's as short as it can get, due to distance. And that's pretty much it. You can, like, have this hidden in a hill or something. Or whatever, because kind of having it on top will be kind of obvious that it's there. And there may be a way to make this more compact. I just didn't do it like that, just to save time. But if you could make this more compact, then you can hide it in smaller places. And as for the redstone one, using command blocks, I already know how you can do it, but I just don't know the codes. Rather than having all this here, just have a single repeater on one tick, have a redstone blocks keep spawning here by the command blocks. And the command blocks will have a repeater between them, at either one or two clicks each, in order to cause a little delay. But you'll need, I think you'll need two command blocks per stage? Not too sure, unless you can get command block to spawn redstone there and there at the same time. And then also turn them to something else. I don't think that'll be actually too difficult, having them turn to something else. And that's pretty much it with this one. I think in my next video, I'll be showing you a little trap I can make in a room that's four blocks wide. Because it'll be very interesting. Especially the way I made it beforehand. Although I've lost that world. I made all sorts of things in the other world. Oh well. Was the trap I plan making is a 2x2 in the middle of a 4-wide room. And I think that'll be it for today's video. Quite short, but oh well. Anyway, if you've enjoyed this video, please leave a like and even subscribe for more episodes. And I will see you all next time. Bye-bye.